Good morning, IC members. Today is a voice inspection day, a mock test. So in the mock test, myself, Ravikant Shinde, principal, Sri Samartha Public School. So Sri Samartha Public School is located near Annapurna Mata Mandir, so at Balapur, Ridhora location. So Sri Samartha Public School is affiliated to Central Board of Secondary Education, and affiliation number is 1130879. School code is 30816. So this is the main gate of the school. So this school is 7 kilometers away from the bus stop and 11 kilometers away from the railway station, and it's reachable to all the students of Akola as well as so this Balapur taluka and all. So this is the boundary wall of the school. Boundary wall is associated with some plants, and then so this side we have the boundary wall of the school, second boundary wall. We do have the security for the campus. So security is always available, 24-hour security. The 3 security personnel, 1 lady personnel is also available. Security check is available. Over here parents gets various different informations, right? Now here, this is school. Is from standard 1 to 10, and we are already affiliated for the upgradation purpose for class 11 and 12 standard. Now we will go ahead for the further campus visit. Let's see now, this is the boundary wall of the school, and we will be entering to see the sports ground and inner area of the school. So let's see further. So this inner area boundary wall, inner boundary wall of the school, and this is the inner boundary wall of the school, school front, front side of the school. And now here the boundary wall of the left hand side of the school, this side, and this way is the front, and that is the right side of the boundary wall. So entire premises of 2 acre, 8100 square meter is the area of the premises. Minimum 2 acres of land is allotted to the CBSE. Now I would like to represent before you the playground area. So this side we can see the playground area. We have 5 grounds. For example, 200 meter track we have. Further we have khokho ground. Along with khokho ground, we too have basketball, then volleyball ground, kabaddi ground, and net cricket for the practice. Students are practicing the net cricket area. Here students are practicing kabaddi. So this is what all grounds we have. So this is the outdoor facility of the ground. Now let's see, we have Manisha Khandezod as a PET teacher, physical education teacher. Here Mr. Mayur, another physical education teacher. So one of my teacher is looking after the area of badminton and basketball. So I request my PET teacher to introduce.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. This is Manisha Khandezod. I done my BPED, MPED in HVPM. Now I take here badminton and basketball. Other games also I teach here, but my main game is basketball and badminton.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Sir. So nice. So please, Mayur. Is Mayur sports teacher?
Hello sir, I am Mayur Nimbalkar. I completed my MPED in HVSKM Yavatmal. In our school we have various sports field. I specialization in hockey.
Right sir, thank you. So nice, both of them, and one more coach we have, Shivaji Chavan, who is looking after the sports ground, especially ground preparation and all. Now look at this side. Here we have net practice. So you can see the net practice we are doing over there. That means cricket bowling and the batting practices always teachers are performing with the students. And here we have kabaddi ground. Due to rain, this is the situation of the ground. But no doubt we are practicing. And further, in connection to that ground, we have a volleyball ground. So in volleyball also students are playing and they are enjoying on the ground. So these are the outdoor facilities. And we too have for the maintenance of the ground, Mr. Shivaji Chauhan. He is a coach, PTI coach, for maintaining the ground and having all the outdoor outdoor infrastructure as well as outdoor ground planning is under him. So please introduce, sir.
Myself Shivaji Chauhan. I'm maintaining the all grounds.
Thank you, sir, for supporting. Let's move on to the another area, that is parking. So we do have the parking area, like on the left hand side of the building we can see the parking area where teachers and the parents, they settle their vehicles, they keep over here. And at this we have another security check, and here is the parking of the four wheeler. So we keep all the parking area away from the students' playground. Now we will be moving to the another area of the sports, that is 200 meter track. So 200 meter track, you can see my sports teachers on the track. So they will be representing the track, and this is a play area, that is a small play area for first and second standard students. So this is what a track, it is marked with a white lines, and this track is for conducting the field and track event. So here we are conducting field and track event from first standard to 10th standard. And for encouraging the students, we too have here such a boards. So these boards are important. These boards encourage students to understand how the sports teacher, sport personnel take efforts in encouraging the things or inculcating the sports in the students. So this is what 200 meter track, and this is the area where we try to encourage the students through the various different sports. Let's move on to the next part, that is another ground. As I already told you, we have 5 to 6 ground, and a total area which is covered for the ground besides building, that is 4000 square meter. 4000 square meter is a area covered for the sports purpose. So this is what my sports teachers are walking on the ground. The lush green ground is available over here. So 4000 plus square meter area is available for the play and other facility. So these are many grounds we will have in the campus. So proposed grounds are also there. This is what Khoko ground, my one of the sports teacher is standing over there. So this is the Khoko ground, the poles are placed. Khoko generally, this is what a board, like Khoko information for the students, those who stand here to watch the game. So they go through the Khoko and they read out the content, read out the information about the sports. So this is all about the Khoko area. Now you can see the track is running, means we have track. The track has covered the inner grounds. So this is what outdoor facilities we have. And this is what handball facility we created in between. So this handball facility, we have for the handball facility, we have for the student. This is the information of the handball and handball equipment we have. Here we do conduct this special sports under the guidance of the qualified sports teachers. Now let's move on to the next part, that is boundary wall. So on the left hand side of the school we have the boundary wall. I'll take a round of the boundary wall now. So this is a boundary wall till the end behind the school. So till that area we have the boundary wall. Okay, besides outdoor facilities, we too have covered entire campus of the school with the help of a boundary. So this is concrete boundary wall. Its height is about approximately 6 feet and above, and entire school building is protected with the help of this boundary wall. and this is the boundary wall till the end. So entire building from the back side as well as the boundary wall we are covering. Now let's move on to the important part of the school. We too have the various different facilities, like all the laboratories, libraries we have. Now I welcome you in the computer lab. Please, thank you. Now here is the computer laboratory. We have Mrs. Deshpande madam, so who is a postgraduate teacher in computer science and HOD of the computer science. Ma'am, please introduce yourself now.
Hello sir, myself Sarika Deshpande. I'm PGT teacher of computer science. We take all syllabus of experience from value of these. Right. So these are all 20 computers. These 20 computers are L computing computers.
Thank you ma'am for introducing the computer lab. So we do have 20 computers over here. So along with the 20 computers, we too have this Digi board for representing whatever the practicals the teacher is conducting on the computer, the same practicals the teacher is representing through this smart board. And this laboratory is internet connected. All the individual, all the terminals are separately connected with the internet facility with a 10 Mbps speed. Thank you ma'am, thank you for representing the computer lab. Thank you. Science lab. We do have science composite lab, science composite lab. So this is what science lab. Extra room is available over here, lady staff room. Let's come on, welcome to the science laboratory. We have science lab on the first floor. So this is the first composite laboratory which we represented at the time of affiliation to secondary level. So this side we have bio section, this side we have physics section, and this side we have chemistry section. Now here we have teacher Mrs. Preeti Pandey.
Hi, myself Preeti Pandey, and I do look after this science composite lab.
This is what the chemistry section of the science lab with all the facilities. So students perform various experiments over here for conducting physics, chemistry and biology experiments, fine. So this is how we have the different various facilities for the students to perform the experiments. So as we are talking about the experiential learning, so here teachers are conducting the experiments along with the students. So this is the live experiment. So this live experiment we can represent from the science lab. Fine, anyway, this is what all facilities are available. Thank you ma'am. Besides this, in the corridor, we too have the evacuation plan for the second floor. So this second floor evacuation plan, left and right side students can move, they can disperse themselves. Now, most important, I welcome you to the biology laboratory. Bio lab is one of the important area. Here we have HOD, head of the biology, Mrs. Archana Bhatte, MSc botany, and Mr. Kaustubh Hande sir, MSc botany. I request now my both the teachers to represent this laboratory. This way you can see over here.
These are the specimens of animals.
Animal specimen, mm-hmm. And the display.
These are the charts. This is human teeth, pedigree analysis. These are some models like amoeba, paramecium.
To facilitate the class 11 and 12 standard teaching, the laboratories have been developed and teachers are looking after each and every area of the laboratory. This side we have physical instruments.
These are compound microscope.
This is what dissecting microscope generally we use for seeing some small objects in the biology. And here is what madam want to say, compound microscope. They are well maintained.
Yes, sir.
And of course, we can see, I think, some of the permanent slides and temporary slides we can make it. Wonderful. Nowadays, we are getting this skeleton. And nowadays, natural skeleton, we are not being as already banned. Just for representing the skeleton to the students. This, just some
these
of
are the human eye, model of human eye. These are the model of human heart.
Yes. Please.
Human ear.
Here another models. And this is what various charts to understand. All these flow charts makes the students means they can make the students understand better. This is what biology laboratory, and bio laboratory is important one to perform various experiments. Here you can see a variety of equipments are kept. Even we do have the autoclave and the oven for making the different things or for support you for the practicals. In biology, we are conducting experiments up to 10th standard. Biology laboratories are valid till 10th standard. 11th definitely we are going to conduct it over here. And we do have the composite laboratory besides this biophysics and chemistry lab. Thank you, ma'am, for representing this biology laboratory in a wonderful way. So thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you. And now let's come to the one part which is very important. That they have bio lab record. Record you can represent. Sorry.
Stock register.
Stock register. Fine. It's okay. Now let's move on to the next. Now let's move on to the next facility, that is chemistry laboratory. Here's the area of a chemistry lab. And in the I welcome you to the chemistry lab. So in the chemistry lab, he's Mr. Harshal Bhakre is a MSc in chemistry and HOD of the chemistry for the school. So I request Mr. Harshal to come along with me to represent this chemistry laboratory. So
Mr. Harshal, please. These are internal instruments used in organic and inorganic chemistry. Then these are powder chemicals which are used in organic and inorganic chemistry practicals. Then here some plastic instruments are here, plastic beakers, then funnels, then measuring cylinders, then volumetric flask and conical flask, then test tube with stands. This is a digital potentiometer which is used in physical chemistry. Then this is magnetic stirrer which is used in organic and inorganic chemistry practicals. These are burette stands, these are burettes and pipettes, these are beakers and glasses, these are liquid chemicals which are used in inorganic and organic chemistry. These are liquid chemicals which are used in organic and inorganic chemistry. Then this is Kipps apparatus which is used to pass H2S gas. Then this is weighing balance for measuring the chemicals. Then these are the dilute solutions. These are dilute solutions which are used for organic and inorganic chemicals. Then here some titrations arrangements are arranged to measure.
Thank you, sir. This is a wonderful trip to laboratory. This is a chemistry lab. All the laboratory equipments we have represented over here. The teacher, Mr. Harshal, has represented over here all the chemical laboratory experiments we can perform. Besides this, we do have the record of the chemistry. So this is what chemical equipment requirement lab, like lab requirement facilities we have, and there are the related records the teacher is maintaining over here. So consumable as well as non-consumable records teacher is being maintained. So these are what the things we have in support to the laboratory. So thank you, sir, for nicely representing the laboratory. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Physics laboratory. So this is another laboratory we have in the science department. Welcome to physics lab. Here we have, I request madam to introduce yourself.
I am Mukta Rao, HOD of Physics.
Okay, please.
This is model of potential meter. We calculate the EMF of two cells. Then the model of crystal meter bridge. We can calculate the resistance of resistance. This is a flywheel. This is a model of Meldes experiment. Models of rolling friction.
Yes.
Law of momentum apparatus. Drawing box. This is spectrometer. That's a weight box. Is the apparatus of sonometer. This is a rheostat. These are resistance box. These are galvanometers, voltmeters, galvanometers, digital multimeters. The kit of resistance in series. Then the activities mode of activities kit, study of household circuits. Is the apparatus of 11th class vernier caliper and glass slab. The lamp of mercury lamp. This is mercury lamp. This is convex lens. This,
all types of lenses we have. Convex, concave, as well as mirror.
This is digital multimeter. This is 11th experiment. Screw gauge. We can calculate the diameters of wire. Then law of parallelogram apparatus. This is a pulley. 2-3 pulleys. A plane mirror. These are plane mirror. Prism. That's prism.
Great. And I hope this is the experiment with the help of which we can form the images. This is all about the physics laboratory. Thank you, ma'am. Wonderfully represented this laboratory. Besides this, I request ma'am to show the record. In physics laboratory, physics experiments, so they do conduct up to 10th standard. The laboratory we have from 7th standard to 10th standard composite laboratory as well as physics special laboratory for the 11 and 12 standard.
These are non-consumable.
This is what non-consumable register we have. This is the certification of the consumable and non-consumable register. So in this way we have all the facility, physics, chemistry and biology. All the facilities have been represented over here. Ms. Sri Samartha Public School affiliated to CBSC New Delhi. Affiliation number is 1130879 and school code is 830816. Have all such facilities for upgradation purpose, and surely we will be having the session on 4th once again. Now let's move on to the next, that is library part. So this is the ground floor facility. So open corridor, porch, and the ground we can see clearly. And this side you can see along on the left hand side of me, like here is a house system. We do follow house system, student council system over here. So in the student council system, we follow house system. Blue, green, red and yellow are the houses, and one is a white house wherein we follow student council system. Let's move on to the next first floor infrastructure. Now let's move on to the first floor of the school building. The first floor, we have a composite science lab, library. Now I welcome you to the library. This is the library. In the library, we have newspaper stand and the magazine stand, as well as some displays of the area of geography. So all the books of library, all the magazines we have over here. So these are the book rack, and in each book rack, is settled with the subject. Subject wise books are kept in the library. Now this is the magazine stand we have, and here student reading area. So here we have student reading area, like all table and partitions are also mentioned over here. So for having the separation of the students for reading purpose. So besides so the student area, students over here they read books. The books of different kind, NCERT books we have private publication books, all the books they read, librarian supplying the books to them for reading purpose, and then they are reading over here. Library one period is given to all the students. Now let us come to this reference book area. We too have the reference books. Now this is what I would like to introduce my librarian, Mrs. Jaya Goje.
Good afternoon.
She is a librarian and maintaining all the records and supporting the students all the time for reading purpose and maintaining the cool atmosphere for the reading purpose. And please introduce.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Jaya Sachin Goje. I am librarian.
Sir, ma'am is maintaining accession register.
Accession register, sir.
Yes.
Magazine register.
Vertical. Hold vertical. This is the magazine register.
Magazine register.
And the student.
Library files, sir.
Library. No.
Book issue registers.
This is what a book issue. This means such all kind of register which are necessary for the students and for maintaining the library, the live library for the student. So she is doing all the time and she is keeping
daily
everything ready. Okay, newspaper like we have. This is what magazine stand. We have the magazines like Competition Success, Science Reporter, Vigyan Pragati. Here we are also taking care of the Hindi language, Marathi language, and all three languages, Marathi, Hindi, and the English, all types of magazines we have of different level. When first standard to 10th standard, we fulfill all the areas of the library. We too have here 2,500 plus books for these students, along with reference books too. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for representing the library. Now, let's move on to the next area. That is what... Now this is what RO room we have, reverse osmosis water plant, and this plant we do maintain to provide the safe drinking water, and we do have the RO water certificate. Now let's see, we have the urinal facility. Every floor urinal toilet facility is available for the boys and girls. Boys and girls, a separate facility is available. There are urinal, 8 urinal per toilet. Including a basin. Total number of 8 urinals, 1 basin and 1 toilet. So in this way we have for the boys.
Go.
Let's see the girls' toilet. Please open. Now let's come to the first floor boys toilet. Now let's come to the ground floor, girls toilet. Here we have the firefighting instrument, reel, so for extinguishing the fire, and the actual control where we can switch on, we can control the fire equipments from here. And let's come to the ground floor toilet, girls toilet. The next area of assembly. Now in the assembly area, this is the left hand side of the building. This is the left hand side of the building. So we have ground plus two floors of the building. The left hand side of the building, it is fitted with the water hose pipe. On the top floor, that means exactly on the top floor, we have the water facility. So fire extinguishers facility, like fire extinguishers and all fire extinguisher equipment along with the necessary motors and all requirements are fulfilled for safety purpose. So school is safer for due to this fire extinguisher. So it is already done. So this is the corridor wherein we have class 11 standard over here, and the corridor which we have in front of the classroom. Let's have a look at the classroom. We have 600 square feet classroom size. So this is what class 11 standard science classroom, right? Here we have classroom size, desk benches. Each room, every classroom we have the 600 square feet size, and also laboratories also we are having the of same size. Fine. Thank you. Let's move on to the next classroom. This is what class 10 standard, Janjira section. Class 10 standard Janjira section. This is a 10 standard classroom. This is a 600 square feet is the size of the classroom. And is the class teacher of a classroom, class 10.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. And this is what board which we are using for the students for writing purpose, that is a whiteboard. Thank you, sir. On the second floor we have here, on the way, girls and boys toilet. This is the girls toilet. Downstairs we have boys toilet, again girls toilet. Alternately on each floor we have the toilet facility for the students. So now we are going to the second floor. Second floor, we are reaching to the corridor of the second floor. Now let's come to the second floor. So before we reach the second floor, we have on the way the firefighting instruments. As I already discussed previously, that firefighting instruments we too have. And here the reel, which covers the entire building of the 100 feet. And water hose additional attachments are given on each floor for the safety purpose. Now here we have the drinking water facility. Here students drink water, we have RO facility, drinking water facility. Now this is the corridor, second floor corridor. And now I welcome you to the sports room. So this is what a sports facility. So to for encouraging the students, so we have placed here the different great sports players so on the wall, so that the students get information about the sports. Sports room. This is what our sports room. Now in the sports room, we have all the various indoor games facility. Like this is what sports teacher. I request sports teacher to introduce the sports room.
Hello sir, this is the sports room. Here is available all equipment, whichever game we are taking outside and inside, means indoor activity and outdoor activity. So this equipment, it is available in this room. See, for example, boxing gloves,
boxing gloves is here. Then after badminton rackets, chess board.
Now see here, students play chess.
And one small match about that, martial arts match. Here we are taking practice about it, taekwondo and martial arts.
And here, Shri Samartha Public School already registered for the Fit India program, and we are also following the Fit India program activities. Besides this, we have all facilities, and this room is decorated so that students should get encouraged to see the sports and just to increase the interest of the students in the area of a sports. So this is what we have, like Fit India program, carom, and all indoor facility, even the skating area, and we are planning to have that archery game too. That means it is under proposal. So this is how we have the sports room along with the sports teacher. This is what one of the facility we provide to the students in the area of sports. We have indoor games, outdoor games, sports teacher to cover up the entire sports area. And we too practice, means we are participating in all the games like district sports office games. Besides district sports office game, we are participating CBSE games and Khelo India events also we are participating. My teachers are registered as ambassadors. Thank you teachers. This is a wide area of corridor now once again. After the math lab, a very important facility which the student need, very important facility which the students required, that is mathematics laboratory. Mathematics is a tough game. It is a tough subject. But this tough subject, we made it easy. So I welcome you to the maths laboratory. Now here, maths laboratory, we have maths teacher Mr. Gajanan Pise. So I request Mr. Gajanan Pise, HOD Mathematics, to introduce the maths laboratory along with the record first. Now here I request sir to show the record.
This is our record of the apparatus that we are using in our maths lab, along with the complete record, so that student can use this for performing different activities in maths lab.
Thank you, sir. Now here you can see various maths experiments. So how you are conducting maths experiments over here?
Actually, we are class-wise, when we want to conduct the activity, we are bringing student in the maths lab, and here they are performing activity under the guidance of respective subject teacher, maths teacher, that they are teaching to them, and they perform here activity, and with the help of activity they get that concept more clarified, and then they can solve or apply that in their day-to-day life properly.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Such a wonderful experience the students they get. Now here beside this we have mathematics laboratory. You can see the pics on the wall, and along both the side of the wall here the artistic designs to encourage, to inculcate the mathematical skills in the students. And they do perform 3rd to 10th standard mathematics experiment over here. And we do have the facility to conduct the experiment of class 11 and 12 as well in the mathematics laboratory. It is under preparation. This laboratory is, we are preparing, because math, so many instruments are there, so many things we have over here out of this. And with so many different papers, we are our math teachers. Besides this one teacher, we have many teachers. They all are using mathematics laboratory. And this laboratory, we are using it from standard 3rd to standard 10. And in future, for 11 and 12 also. Thank you, sir. Now, let's move on to the next facility, that is music. Here, see, on the way in the corridor, we have placed some boards. That is called the evacuation plan of the second floor. So this evacuation plan of the second floor represents that how the students will move from left hand side as well as from the right hand side of the building, so at the time of natural calamity. Besides this, we have firefighting instruments near the laboratories, and the wide area is there as a fresh airy atmosphere we have in the school. Now let's move on to the next facility. We have music. Music is the heart of the school. So this music is the heart of the school. And as music is the heart of the school, you can see over here, to encourage the students in the area of music, we have placed the great musician's portrait so that the students will understand or they get encouraged. So welcome to the music room. This is what we have, the music room. The board is displayed. with some Aroha Saregama Padanisa and Avaroha. And here we have musical instruments, octopad, violin, and of course we worship over here. Here is a music teacher, Mr. Avinash Todsam. I request Avinash Todsam to represent the musical notes. Thank you. Now let's move on to the next facility available in the school, that is art and craft room. Now this is what art and craft room is, a very important area of the school. Please. Here we have Mr. Ganesh Sangade, the maths art teacher, right? Now let's move on to the another area, like this is what decoration of the art and craft, and here we have a craft material. Mrs. Sheetal Tale will represent the craft. Now this craft, every day students prepare something or other under the guidance of art teacher, and they keep on making various different material, craft material, and we do follow NCERT guidelines syllabus given for the completing the art course. It is up to 10th standard we are conducting. So this is what art room is, very well decorated by Mr. Ganesh Sangade. This is what a board, always generally they some or other thing they represent, like sometime craft, sometime other area they represent, and here is a place of a teacher under whose guidance and the control the students learn. So this artistic views. Thank you sir. Here now we will be moving to the another area of the school. Now, besides this laboratory, the science, now we will be going for the class 12 room. Now this is what class 12 room. Class 12, class 12 room we have, right? This is what class 12 room we have. Now here, from here you can see it's clearly visible from here that you can see the 200 meter track of the ground. So this track, students every day practice on the ground. The track is well planned, 200 meter track, all physical facility outdoor as well as indoor. So this is what a track we are following. You can see, at this place 200 meter track, and on the 200 meter track students are practicing athletics. Let's see, today we are going, we have already done with our infrastructure. Now the documentation part, let's come to the documentation part. So we submitted DEO certificate, District Education Office certificate. So this is the first certificate as per affiliation bylaws. So appendix 3, so that we have done. So this is the first page of this DO certificate, the second page of the DO certificate. On the second page, here point number 14 I would like to stress, that are both the school and the playground situated in a single compound bounded by a single continuous boundary wall on all sides. So it is yes, and it is done. So you can see through my videos. This is the third page of the appendix 3 and the signatures of the concerned authority. This is what for the certificate in connection proof. Now next certificate, that is affidavit annexure 4. So this is what annexure 4, it is the affidavit stating all the point as per affiliation bylaws 2018. Now let's see the pages of it. This is the first page of affidavit. So the signatures, affidavit confirmation notary. And this is what trustee list. Now next, fire safety certificate. This is the fire safety certificate. So all the fire equipments we already placed in, and this is what certificate of it. This is affiliation bylaws. Sorry, this is what building safety certificate we have in a vernacular language, and the same building certificate we have. This is what our affiliation bylaws. This is the affiliation bylaws. Shri Samartha Public School affiliation bylaws, and in the bylaws we have already got this certificate, that is building safety certificate. And this building safety certificate is valid. It is English, and so this certificate is in Marathi, and this vernacular language is translated into English. This is a translated part. Okay, and this is notary is also done for the same thing. Thank you. Next, this one is a sanitary certificate. Sanitary certificate of 1 year. This is the second certificate called pro forma regarding the safe drinking water and sanitary certificate. Now let's move on to the admin block area. So A to H, all the category documents we are maintaining in the admin block. So please. This is the admin block. Account position, accountant Mr. Mayur. Here we have senior student section, and here we have documentation. So please open. Here we are maintaining all the documents like admission forms, then all teachers, student notices, CCA activities, HR section appointments of all the teachers. Here we have many other student section, UDIS section, CBSC section, then student enrollment with the regional office, then audit reports, all such required report we are representing over here in all the files. Now I request Mr. Deepak to open the second compartment. Now here in this section, the teachers training required for the staff, that we are maintaining teachers training A to H. Besides teacher training, we too have the outward record and the inward record of all the file, website details and scholarship form. Fine. Next. And we do follow all the committee, that means anti-sexual harassment committee, working committee, school management committee. So all the records of all the committees are maintained. So over here, this is what A to H area. So we are representing in the school all the records centralized way we are maintaining over here, even PF documents, salary sheet, all areas, audit report, everything we are maintaining over here. So hope so this virtual mock test is very fine, and we will see you on 4th. Thank you all.